go. So that's 2024. Still another seven or so of us. This is Red Road. It's a house that's been in the north of Glasgow, and it's quite famous. A, because it's so big. Easily the tallest buildings in Glasgow. And where, in terms of residential buildings, at one point the tallest in Europe, they've been surpassed by other countries since. And they certainly become an icon of modernist architecture and how people feel about it, and often used and exploited by filmmakers, artists and entertainment as a sort of dystopian nightmare. What you find when you come here is very different. It's a community. It's a very large community, or rather communities. Each block in a sense is its own neighbourhood. And what you realise when you actually talk to people here and get to know them is that as with anything else, if a tower block is what you have to make a home in and a life in, then people do that. And for the most part, the reputation of the place is vastly overstated. Like I said, that it's an interest. It's not a place I personally choose to live in, because I don't like being too high. I'm used to low slung thing, homes on wheels, I think you could say. What I'm doing here is I'm working with tenants and people who work here to try and reconstruct, recreate and depict the places they live in and lived in. So the drawing in there just now is of the concierge station, and comes from quite a lot of work with the concierges themselves, trying to find out about their job and what they do and what happens in the station that they use, which is a flat at the bottom of this block here. So being able to be up here and draw here is really useful for two reasons. One is practical. It being a modern block, basically the same pattern had been used for building it everywhere. So if I need to check the details of the balcony, for example, how the grab rail looks and so forth, I can do that. I can go and double check and look at another things like a light box and so forth, and double check my details are okay. But it's also, I think, good to get the soul and the spirit of the place and the feel of it as well, which is much more intangible and much more voodoo, and it's I tried to explain that you get into much more spiritual and voodoo territory almost. But for me, it is quite good to be able to go to a place and see it and feel it and suck it up and get a sense of it, even if I'm not drawing it there and then. But being able to actually draw in here is certainly a bonus. So to have the space here for work is good. So with the Boswell idea, it's similar. I really like to go to the place, and I think be able to go to somewhere like, say, the Grass Market in London, a coffee house in London, or Mull, and see these places for myself, will be useful, not just for detail, not so much for detail even, I think more for getting the feel right and how I feel about it, because the drawings are affected by how I feel about this as well, I think.